What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, undefeated, rising welterweight, Mexican superstar title contender, King Rod, Ryan Garcia, 21 wins, no losses, no draws, 18 wins by way of knockout, 23 years of age, 5'10" with a 70-inch arm reach. Well, he takes to social media. He initially announces that he has a big fight coming up. And then he takes to social media once again and he says, this fight is going to be well worth the wait. Hinting at he could possibly be facing undefeated three-division world champion, superstar boxer, Gervonta Tank Davis, who is 26 wins, no losses, no draws, 24 wins by way of knockout, 5'5" with a 67-inch arm reach, 27 years of age. With that said, Ryan Garcia and Gervonta Tank Davis, they were in talks some time back, and the fight never came to fruition. Well, because Ryan Garcia, he stated after his fight with Olympic gold medalist, British superstar title contender, Luke Campbell, back in January of this year, where he got a 7th-round TKO victory over Luke Campbell after being floored in a fight with Luke Campbell. Ryan Garcia, in that fight, he became the mandatory to undefeated WBC lightweight world champion superstar boxer Devin the Dream Haney, who is 27 wins, no loss, no draws, 15 wins by way of knockout, 23 years of age, 5'8" with a 72-inch arm reach, and has an extensive history with Ryan Garcia in the amateurs, in which I believe they fought 4 times, and Devin Haney says he was 3-1 against Ryan Garcia. Ryan Garcia says it was 2-2. Nonetheless, after he beat Luke Campbell, he became the mandatory challenger for Devin Haney and Devin Haney's WBC title, in which Ryan Garcia, he's told Devin Haney face-to-face immediately after the fight that if he can't secure a victory against or a showdown with Gervonta Tank Davis, he'll revisit the possibility of fighting Ryan Garcia, Devin Haney. With that said, it was talks that Ryan Garcia and Gervonta Tank Davis entered negotiations. We know there's a history because their promoters are rivals. Ryan Garcia's promoter is Olympic gold medalist, 5-division world champion, Hall of Fame, iconic, legendary superstar boxer, Oscar the Golden Boy De La Hoya, who is also now promotional company, Golden Boy Promotions, CEO and founder, Oscar De La Hoya. And obviously, Gervonta Tank Davis, his promoter, is undefeated, legendary, iconic, 5-division world champion, superstar boxer, former pound-for-pound king, the man known as Money, Floyd Money Mayweather Jr., who retired 50-0, and he beat Oscar De La Hoya, and at the time, that was the biggest lucrative fight in the history of the sport of boxing back in 2007. So with that said, they have a natural rivalry because Oscar De La Hoya is always calling for a rematch with Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather won a split decision over Oscar De La Hoya. Oscar De La Hoya was the cash cow. He had a 70-30 split in his favor, chose the ring size, chose the weight class they fought at, chose the date and the location. Even chose Floyd Mayweather's gloves. And Floyd Mayweather obliged because he said, after I beat Oscar De La Hoya, well, I'm going to be the man to beat. And he was just that. So with that said, they have a natural rivalry, okay? And the talks begin, and we know Ryan Garcia, he went on legendary retired Hall of Famers podcast, that being Iron Mike Tyson, and he was on the podcast with Iron Mike Tyson, and he called Gervonta Tank Davis. They FaceTimed him, and he told Mike Tyson and Tank Davis that he was going to knock Tank Davis out in the 1st round, 2nd round, the latest, and it never came to fruition because, according to Oscar De La Hoya, he embellished and stated that he suddenly had an opportunity to fight legendary 8-division world champion, iconic Filipino superstar boxer, Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao. Well, Pacquiao and his team, they stated that was never true. They had zero interest in fighting Ryan Garcia. And they even told Ryan Garcia, if he kept up with the false statements, that they were willing to go the legal route. And so from there, Ryan Garcia, he was scheduled to face off against another mandatory WBC challenger for Devin Haney in Javier Fortuna. Well, Ryan Garcia, he then pulled out the fight with Javier Fortuna. And he cited that he had health issues that he had to attend to and that, you know, he needed to take some time off with his family, so on and so forth. Okay, so Another fighter stepped in for Ryan Garcia, that being former IBF super featherweight world champion Mexican superstar boxer Joseph Jojo Diaz. Okay, he stepped in for Ryan Garcia, moved up in weight, challenged Javier Fortuna. Joseph Diaz, 32 wins, 2 losses, 1 draw, 15 wins by way of knockout, 29 years of age, 5'6" with a 64-inch arm reach. He stepped in, okay, July 9th, okay? That was supposed to be the fight for Ryan Garcia. So Joseph Diaz, he wins a unanimous decision against Javier Fortuna. Well, then Joseph Diaz is then scheduled to face Ryan Garcia in December. Well, Ryan Garcia, once again, he pulls out the fight. As Joseph Jojo Diaz predicted, he pulled out the fight. Now, Joseph Diaz, ironically enough, he became the mandatory for Devin Haney. And then Joseph Diaz, he decided, well, after claiming that he wanted to fight Devin Haney, that he was just going to fight Ryan Garcia because he felt it was more lucrative and a more winnable fight. And it never came to fruition. So he ended up facing Devin Haney. And Devin Haney, December 4th, beats Joseph Diaz unanimous decision. So with that said, Ryan Garcia, he witnesses Gervonta Tank Davis fight another fighter December 5th against Isaac Pitbull Cruz, okay? Who was a fill-in for WBA, World Boxing Association's interim champion in Rolando Rolly Romero, who was 14 wins, no loss, no draws, 12 wins by way of knockout, 27 years of age. 5'7", 5'8", with a 70-inch arm reach. He was supposed to face off against Gervonta Tank Davis, but due to some legal accusations against him, alleged, you know, he had to be pulled from the fight, which saw Mexican star boxer Isaac Pitbull Cruz, who was 22 wins, 1 loss, 1 draw, 15 wins by way of knockout, 23 years of age, 5'3", with a 63-inch arm reach, replace Rolando Rolly Romero. Now, he gave Gervonta Tank Davis a tougher fight than most people expected and anticipated. And Ryan Garcia, he immediately took to social media and he stated that he would beat Isaac Pitbull Cruz pretty handily, pretty easy, because he's a C-level fighter. Now, keep in mind, he was supposed to face Joseph Jojo Diaz, but he claimed he had a broken hand. That's important to note. And now, after Gervonta Tank Davis wins a unanimous decision over Isaac Cruz, who Ryan Garcia claims is a C-level fighter, now he claims he'll beat Isaac Cruz pretty handily, pretty easy. And he starts calling for a fight. And Isaac Cruz, he says, well, I'll oblige you. Let's make it happen. And Ryan Garcia states that they enter negotiations. They're going to send him a contract. Then he says the fight could possibly be on the horizon. Well, then Golden Boy Promotions handlers started to tell the world, well, they don't know if they're too interested in making this fight because Isaac Pitbull Cruz is a very tough customer, very awkward, a pressure fighter, and has a tough head, a hard head. And for somebody in Ryan Garcia's position who badly hurt his hand, might not be the smartest fight and right way to go, seeing as though he had been out the ring for quite some time on top of that. So Ryan Garcia, by the time he fights again, would have been out the ring for over a year because we're heading into January. And the last time he fought was January of this year. Okay, the first quarter and the first month of this year. And now we're heading into January this Saturday. Okay, the new year is this Saturday, this Sunday. So with that said, now he would have been out the ring for a year. And Golden Boy is saying they want a tune-up fight for Ryan Garcia. Well, Ryan Garcia is back at it on social media claiming that he could possibly be facing Gervonta Tank Davis or Isaac Pitbull Cruz. But he's more alluding to Gervonta Tank Davis when he claims the long wait is going to be well worth it. Or is he indicating that he could be fighting Devin the Dream Haney? Well, we know that's not going to happen because Devin Haney, he's looking to face off against newly crowned unified lightweight world champion Australian star boxer George Kambosos Jr. He's 20 wins, no loss and no draws, 10 wins by way of knockout, 28 years of age, 5'9" with a 70-inch arm reach. He shockingly defeated former unified lightweight world champion superstar boxer Teofimo Lopez November 27th, shockingly, and won a split decision. So Devin Haney, he's looking to become undisputed, as George Kambosos Jr. is claiming that that's what the route he wants to go. And we know Ryan Garcia has no interest in fighting two-time Olympic gold medalist, three-division world champion, former unified lightweight world champion, Ukrainian superstar boxer Vasyl Hightech Lomachenko. So Ryan Garcia is alluding to a Gervonta Tank Davis fight. Now, we know Gervonta Tank Davis also broke his left hand in the fight with Isaac Pitbull Cruz. So with that said, Gervonta Tank Davis' comeback date is in limbo. But we also know Rolando Rolly Romero, who's his Gervonta Tank Davis's WBA interim mandatory challenger, according to WBA, he's calling for the fight and saying he's next. So we have to see how that plays out. But Ryan Garcia, once again, is becoming a social media, dare you say, troll for the sport of boxing. Because he's calling out a lot of fighters. He has a lot of things to say, but he's not making any of these fights happen. So now he's alluding to the Gervonta Tank Davis fight coming to fruition, or the Isaac Pitbull Cruz fight coming to fruition, and saying the announcement is coming soon enough, and it's going to be well worth the long wait. Well, his handlers have other things and other plans. Ryan Garcia is doing a lot of call-outs, but doing none of the fighting. So let's see how this all unfolds and plays out. That's all I got for y'all. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
You know what it is, your boy Jaden Kiss. Make sure you check out Blue Blood Sports TV. It's going down.